the last one. I want first to thank Sylvie Patry and Tom Collins of the Bard Foundation for the invitation to participate in this beautiful event. It's a nice way to keep living Matisse than organizing such a symposium. I want also to thank in advance all the public who stay and who will have to endure the worst French accent. I want to apologize for that. Dear Sylvie, it was a good idea to place my communication at the end of the symposium, I think. Bringing a Matisse collection to life in a museum setting, what a question. What a problem also when your museum is isolated in a rural territory. Of course, Matisse still exercises a great power of fascination and attraction. Recent and successful exhibition organized by my distinguished colleague prove that. But to renew the interest of visitors, search of new audience, you need to show conviction to bring them in Le Cateau-Cambrésis. So perhaps now I can to show you where is Le Cateau-Cambrésis. So Matisse, you see, it's here. We are here in the world. Not too far from the Belgian border. So now you know where is the museum. The Matisse Museum in Le Cateau is not located in a tourist area. This part of northern France is primarily agricultural and in a region of great economic and social difficulty. The museum also has another role in the addition to its cultural mission. It's a structural element of a local development, a key player in the development of the tourism economy. A strong pressure is on us, on the part of elected official people, of tourism and on economic world, but also by the lover of Matisse who always want to request more quality in our exhibition. Also, to sustain the museum, we base our work on the organization of regular exhibition, in particular trying to find a little or not no element of the work of Matisse. Also trying to find the links with this territory to make the first, local people first Matisse ambassador. To illustrate my point, I will take an example, the last four exhibitions we made. Weaving Matisse, Matisse cut into color, Matisse and engraving the other instrument, and Matisse rhythm and meaning. Each exhibition develops a theme that meets this desire to discover and live Matisse. Each of these exhibitions we will discuss could be organized with the commitment and generosity of the Matisse family. I should like to thank them, and I also thank the museum colleague with whom we work regularly. I've not addressed here voluntary temporary exhibition dedicated to contemporary artists that also help illustrate Matisse influence on contemporary creation. As you know, Matisse was born in Le Cateau, 7,000 inhabitants. I show you not so far from Belgian border in the region of Picardy. He found the museum in 1952. 2 years before his death, in the town hall that has seen generations of Matisse in the wedding hall. That was the town hall. The first Matisse Museum was here, and now it's a new Matisse Museum. This picture is took by a plane. There is no skyscraper in Le Cateau. The museum was then transferred to a former palace of Fénelon, and in 2002, the museum was expanded and the Northern Department took the leadership. This area was an important industrial region, including at the time of Matisse production of textiles. Matisse spent his childhood in Bohain, surrounded by those producers of colored silks, the radiating decorative motif. That's the museum. That's the house in Bohain. And that's the type of textiles which was made in Bohain, like with a lot of color. And of course, we just spoke about the decorative. No, that's not that way. You can see all this motif absolutely clear. The first exhibition, Weaving Matisse. Tisser Matisse en français. This exhibition was created to remember the influence of the textile design, decorative motif, color in the work of Matisse. This territory was home for over 300 years of a family of weavers, the Matisse family. We forget that the Matisse family was a family weavers for 300 years. I think it can explain a lot of things after. So the past, the history, the heritage of the environment that tells the exhibition make it clear that it's not possible to consider the work of Matisse without considering the influence of the north of France. Textiles, in all its form, has passed through the work of Matisse. The exhibition features textiles which belong to Matisse from all sources and origin, with a significant portion dedicated to Polynesia. See other type of textiles, and you have this type of book who was made each year for the, what we call the collection with different textiles made each year. All tapestry made by Matisse were also met as a test made to Usher. With original drawing of Jacinthe Gertrude for the occasion. So here we have some pictures of the exhibition. You have typically two shawls whose name is a shawl of Bohain. One belonged to Matisse, and a typical weaver machine, weaving loom, who come from Bohain at this time. As I said, all the tapestry, we spoke about that yesterday, was brought together. You have Tahiti 1, Tahiti 2, fenêtre à Tahiti 1 et fenêtre à Tahiti 2, Océanie, le ciel.
Wait, are you saying those are tapestries?
Yeah, that's tapestry because what we saw here, it was a tapestry, a tenture made by Usher. It's not the paper cutout. Usher was an Englishman who made, we speak about that after, but who make a tapestry to Matisse, for Matisse. You have the two one, and when I say that Matisse was very disappointed by the second version of Femme aux luttes, it's really true because it's incredible that the weaver made so a big mistake when he makes the second version of Femme aux luttes. Also, we just saw Mimosa. We have one type of chasuble. Polynesia. Verdure here. It was very interesting to discover the Usher archive. We saw in these pictures the trying made by Usher for making a textile by Matisse with a different type of color of textiles, and the motif came from a drawing made by Matisse. This knowledge of textiles, this mastery of techniques we discovered from Matisse has also helped to understand that it was essential in achieving the paper cutout. That will be another story. as you, different type of test. Finally, there is one textile made, but Matisse only made one dress with these textiles and don't want to make any more textiles with the research of Asher. We have a square made by Matisse from Asher. Asher made a different type of square. One for Picasso, it was for a charity business, and we have trying with other color made at the beginning. Finally, it's a blue one we made. We rediscover the dessin, the drawing of Jacinthe. And you see, it was made for textile. The mastery of scissors is essential also in the story of paper cutout, but we'll text about them then later. The exhibition has strengthened the knowledge around the work involving textile dimension in Matisse work. We were able to collect all his tapestry. We identified three drawings of Pierre Antana Matisse collection as relating to Polynesia tapestry. We found the textile testing and drawings made to Asher, we just saw. Finally, we received from Mrs. Barbara Dutuy the important gift or rare Bohun shawl from the collection of Matisse that we are here. That was the drawing we found in Pierre Antana Matisse Foundation. It was really a surprise, and we understand, we was with George and Vanda in this time, I remember, and we was very excited by that. It was a try for Polynesia, and what is also very interesting is to see with the bird that we have the cover of jazz here. So we understand also that for this trying of Polynesia, Matisse have had a project to make two Polynesia and a carpet in the office of the President de la République in the Élysée, but it never happened. We can see the many beneficial aspects arising from this exhibition that has fascinated weavers still active on the area and made Matisse closer, more affordable for local people, including many textiles workers who do not usually come to our museum. The link with the scissors and cutting is done naturally with the next exhibition, Matisse Cutting in Two Colors. I stress the generosity of the Matisse family to the museum. In 2012, we received the gift of more than 400 paper elements cut by Matisse. These elements were used by Matisse, which finally has not incorporated them in his work. This extraordinary collection, which has never been presented before, included elements that tell the evolution of paper cutout used for jazz, through the Oceania until the very last one. We could discover the original color used by Matisse. Somebody speak about this morning the degradation of paper cutout. With this donation, we can have the first color, and it was very interesting to see the true color. But mostly, we discovered the phenomenon of work in progress, how from a Matisse form will create another one that will provoke a new one. With the pictures, it will be more clear. Here you have a type of element we receive in the donation. And you see, it was a trying for Polynesia. And finally, Matisse don't include it in the final composition. We have Also, the true Océanie, le ciel, et Océanie, la mer, the true paper cutout. And in the donation, we receive a lot of this element. We show like that because we always want to make people understand that it's not work, it's not artwork, it's element, it's a material, and it has not the statue of artwork, but it's wonderful. And you can find in all Oceania and for the two Oceania, the different form. You can find the flower, you can find the border. See, you have the bird. You have very, very interesting. You have a lot of them. Only Matisse know why at this moment he don't use this bird. He don't belong to the harmony, as he said. He have to be in the good music. We discover with this donation a very interesting thing, what I call the work in progress for Matisse. When Matisse went in Tahiti, he saw a lot, he make diving, and he saw a lot of fish and different animals. And when he make his paper cutout, he have his mind different type of fish, and he make it in paper cutout. Like, for example, this form, typically like a fish we have in Tahiti. This form, after is transformed, he cut, you know, the wings, he cut, and it's become this form. With the form we saw just before, with four form, we have this form. So it's very interesting. We saw that on that one, it's 1, 2, 3. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4. And after this form is new, he work again on this form. And we find this type of form in the chasuble, for example, or you have that in the book of Verde. And the form, you see, you find it in the stained glass of poisson chinois, Chinese fish, we have in our museum. You have a lot of different color, and you have also this relation between inside, outside, like a sculpture. Just have to find. It was also verified that for Matisse, there is several different type of paper cutout. Some are close to painting, others are close to the sculptures. Others are made for textiles or stained glass. I think that the contribution of this exhibition to the knowledge of the work of Matisse was very important, in addition to a time when Tate and MoMA organized the so beautiful presentation. See. We have, for example, this form. It's come from the swirler in jazz. You have the knife, the sword, and the man who hit the sword, and it just comes from that. So it's a play, it's a game to find in each work what we can find. And also, as I said, we have the true color, and you know how Matisse was exigent about the color used for his paper cutout. For example, we have the carton for vigne, for the stained glass vigne in our museum, and you can put in relation these different type of elements. I will speak now about another exhibition whose name is Matisse and Engraving, the Other Instrument. Pursuing this desire to discover the lesser known aspect of the work of Matisse with a contribution of unknown element. This exhibition could be organized thanks to Barbara Dutuis in memory of the generosity of Claude Dutuis to our museum. Nearly 200 works summarizing the Matisse engraving work from the first set portrait from 19 until 1944. All types of techniques used by Matisse, linocut, monotype, lithography, woodcut, dry point and etching, sugar lift aquatint, were shown. And most truly enriched by the presentation for the first time of the matrix on which Matisse worked. Woodcut, lithostone, copper plates, linocut, work by Matisse. Also, I want to show you. So the first one, a tribute to Rembrandt. We have Le Grand Bois. So you have we show the wood and the print. And here's the type of plate. You have linocut. It's a view of the lithostone. Of the exhibition, we explain because it's not easy to make an exhibition about. We have to explain the different technique of engraving, and we show the different matrice and the lithostone. We have here two type of stone. Most truly enriched, also note that Matisse only allowed a very limited distribution of engraving works, sometimes only one run, like a very beautiful stone litho show here, that one. Matisse only print one example of this litho stone. Discover also stripe prints with a change in the way of scrunching plates. See, we exhibit the print, the plate we scratch here at this time, and in the time we discover that the scratch become more and more little, and as there is a type of respect for the matrice, and we don't find at the hand a lot of scratch on the plate, but just a little line to prove that that's the final work. Cantate de Katia. We were able to enrich the museum collection by purchasing a lithography stone from the Mourlot collection, who represents the dancer acrobat. It was. It's that one. Yep. Compliqué ça. That one. The exhibition was very successful, and I think that has enabled our public understanding of the importance of Matisse engraving work and the freedom he has won for his research on the engraving technique. The last exhibition I want to talk to you just ended. Matisse Rhythm and Meaning took place in Johannesburg. It was the first Matisse exhibition on the African continent. She addressed two topics, the relationship between Matisse and Africa and the idea of freedom, this term being declined in several sense. Beyond the enormous success of attendance and media, the greatest satisfaction for me was the important pedagogic work implemented. Few view of the exhibition. It was also interesting to see the still life with African sculptures with the two iris and coquelicot. For example, we transform abuse in an artistic practice studio like a workshop, and we went into old school in the township of Soweto. In some schools, the children has never used a color pencil before. The practice of paper cutout, beside the joy of the children, also made it clear to teachers who absolutely not practice the art, this had a beneficial effect for children. They could see that the calm that prevailed in the class, in the class you have 64 pupils in the morning and the same after the lunch. But it was also very important for teachers to discover that children was able to invent and do works that they not had before suspected. We have few pictures of school here, and we make a lot of documents, and was very happy with the French ambassador and to make a paper cutout. It was very a great pleasure for these children. We made understand now how Matisse were an artist, not only French, but a universal artist, playing with civilization, mixing history, and transcending religion. A beautiful message of tolerance brought even then France had at this time to undergo horrific attack. I say you that we have a wonderful, successful communication around the exhibition, such in France also, but as such a San Diego newspaper wrote about this exhibition, and it was very funny to see how it was tell about the first Matisse exhibition in Africa. Finally, I want to introduce you to a project that will allow the Matisse Museum to grow and continue to live. The expansion provided in the covered market. It's here. You have the museum and the covered market is just here. You have the door here. This will give us the opportunity to redeploy collection, show the things we were pressing not before, presenting not before, to better accommodate children and develop tourism and economic attractiveness of Cateau-Cambrésis. We have a project that will enable the museum, created by Matisse, stay a living place, a place of discovery, a place of research, but also a fun place. For we must not forget the Matisse message to the inhabitants of Le Cateau at the opening of the museum in 1952. I quote, "My fellow citizens of Le Cateau, I left so fast to go where my destiny leads me, wanted to honor my working life through the creation of this museum. I realized that all the hard work of my life was for the human family, which was to be revealed a bit of the fresh beauty of the world through me. I have therefore been a medium." Besides this exhibition, activity to keep the museum and its collection as a living place, it seems to me it must first preserve the spirit in which Matisse created it. I thank you and wait you soon in Le Cateau.